Hi guys and welcome back to my channel. My name is Vivicat and I like to do face transformation makeup tutorials. Today's makeup is inspired by Ishihara Satomi, very famous Japanese actress. I look very different from her, but I try. And here is a before and after makeup comparison. I hope you will like today's tutorial. First, base makeup. I'm taking a concealer that is 2 shades lighter than my own skin tone and putting it on the areas where I want to highlight and where I have discolorations, and blending it out with a concealer brush. To keep the makeup lightweight and feeling good on my face, I am just applying foundation on the areas where I have larger pores and where I have acne scars, aka not the areas I have just applied concealer. I don't like cake face. And I'm just setting the base makeup with a powder, and now let's move on to the eyebrows. And here is a before and after makeup comparison on the eye area. Enjoy the difference. Let's start with the frame of the face, the eyebrows. Ishihara Satomi has quite straight and thin eyebrows, but my face is a bit bigger than hers, so really thin brows would not suit my face shape. So I decided to draw on my eyebrows a little bit thicker than hers, and then I'm cleaning up the edges with concealer to make them look more on fleek. And I also colored my brow hair lighter with an eyebrow mascara to match my hair color. Okay, now when the frame of the face is down, let's move on to the eye makeup. First, I am curling every each one of my almost not there invisible eyelashes, and then covering them in a lot of mascara. Since Ishihara Satomi has double eyelid, so today I'm creating double eyelid with a mascara. It's really simple physics. It's like when you have fat on your stomach, you sit down and there will be a fold. When the lashes pushes up the eyelid, there will be a fold as well. This way of creating double eyelid only works on people like me who have fatter upper lid. It will not work on very thin monolid because you need that fat to create a fold. Maybe it sounds very strange, but that's how it works. And I'm taking a dark brown shade and putting it at outer and inner corner of my over eyelid, and with the same dark brown shade, I'm also putting it at my lower eyelid and a little bit at the inner corner of my lower eyelid to open up the eyes even more. And that's it for today's eyeshadow. Very simple, right? And after that, I'm applying eyeliner. Since my eyelid is still hiding a lot of that eyelid, so I still need to draw on my eyeliner quite thick for it to be visible when I have my eyes open. And this is how it looks. To make the eyeliner look softer than it is, I am taking a very dark brown shade and smudging out the line of my eyeliner to make the eye look softer. I don't have that much of upper lashes, so I chose to put on a very natural pair of falsies as well, and then I applied some mascara at my lower lashes to enlarge the eyes even more. Ishihara Satomi have very large tear bags, as they call it in Asia, and so to create that fake tear bag, I am putting a lighter shade of concealer on the area where I want the tear bag, and then I'm taking an eyebrow powder and putting it underneath the highlight area to create a natural shadow. I think this is the most natural way to create a fake tear bag. I mean, it's still flat if you see it from the side, but at least it looks pretty real in pictures. And then I also applied some glittery eyeshadow on the highlighted area to make it pop up even more. And since I'm missing some of that eyelash hair at the end of my lower eyelid, so I decided to draw it on with my eyeliner. And here we go, the eye makeup is done. It's very simple, I think. You can skip the tear bag if you don't like it, because some people think it looks like airbags, but it is tear bags. It's a good thing, apparently. And now I'm just contouring my nose, and as you can see here, the tear bag looks super real from afar. And since I'm filming a tutorial, so I film everything very close up, which can make it look like it is a lot, but it is not. Nobody will be 2 centimeters away from your face. If they are, then they are too close. For the blush, I am putting it on the apples of my cheeks, but a little bit higher than I usually do. This way of applying blush should bring you a more youthful and cheerful look. Personally, I think Ishihara Satomi's most special facial feature is her lips. Her lips are really plump and they are quite rounded. They don't really have edge and it looks super, super dewy and cute. So I chose to straight up outlining my lips with a lip gloss to make them thicker, plumper and more like her lips.So this is really the last step of this makeup. I'm just putting on more gloss because I feel for it. I know I look very different from Ishihara Satomi, but if I like someone's makeup and I want to recreate that look, there is nothing stopping me from it. I think the beauty in makeup is you can really transform yourself into looking someone badass, someone super cute, someone super sexy. For me, I feel like what's the fun part of the makeup if you can'ttransform yourself into looking like whoever you want, whoever you feel for. And this makeup look must be one of the most natural makeup I have ever done in this channel. I hope you like it. You can go to the school with it, you can go to the bank with it, you can go to meetings with it, you can go to on dates with it, and just change out the lip color to whatever color you feel for. So thank you so much for watching today's video, and if you want to, you can also subscribe to my YouTube channel for more videos in the future. And if you miss me here on YouTube, I also have an Instagram, same username as here, VivyCat. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!